Dollywood, guys. We in Dollywood. There's Lightning Rod. I'm freaking out. We about to go to Lightning Rod. I'm actually kind of losing it right now. It's so immersive, though. Like, this place is freaking crazy. Look at this. Heck yes. Look at this. Oh, my God. This, what the heck? Here we go. Oh my God, dude. Holy crap. Oh my God. Okay, we got row 4. I asked for the back row. They just put me in row 4. Couldn't really control that, but holy crap, dude. I'm actually gonna lose it. Okay, I just got first ride of the day, row 4 of Lightning Rod. Okay, I'm gonna be honest, it's good. It's not fantastic. That said, it is first ride of the day, and it was row 4. So I do think that this could, like right now, yeah, it goes far as saying it's like on par with Zeus at Mount Olympus. But I know that the more I ride, the better it's gonna get, especially considering it's a hot day. I think it's gonna warm up, and it's gonna shoot up in my rankings, I already know. So, yeah, so much fun. Yeah, we're gonna go a couple more times on this thing. So I just got off Lightning Rod, row 11. Okay, that thing is bonkers. That thing is bonkers. All right, constant ejector. There is some, like, a little bit of, like, a rattle, like, a little bit of rattliness over, like, right after the wave turn and, like, through the second twist and shout. But other than that little bit of rattliness, it's glossy smooth. It's one of the best rides I've ever ridden. I don't even know where it ranks yet. I gotta soak it in. Gotta really think about it. But, yeah, it's one fantastic ride. It's amazing. Front row ride on Thunderhead, first CCI. That was amazing, dude. Every hill, like, delivered with, like, super strong floater. Some of the turns are actually, like, really smooth, like, smoother than some steel coasters. It's so much fun, dude. It's so much fun. All right, we're gonna get catch a back row ride, hopefully. Yeah. I tried to ask the back row last time they gave me the front, which, and not mad. But you know, hopefully we get back. Anyway, yeah, let's take it back. We just got off of Thunderhead back row. Okay, that thing's actually bonkers. I don't know. I can't tell if it's my favorite ride in the park, just because I haven't gotten like a truly back row ride on El Rod, and it was like first and like fifth ride of the day. So I can't tell. I don't know. That Thunderhead's really good. That is amazing. Thunderhead, GC. I'm already a GC5 fan. I'm already a GCI fan. That thing is crazy. All right, yeah. I think we're going to Wildwood Grove and go to Dragonfly next. So, yeah. Okay, I just got off of Dragonfly. That ride was unreal. it is, I mean, we got front row and just, it's so smooth. I mean, it's forceful as heck. It is just, it's so much fun. I mean, that's a coaster where it's like, it's not positive G-Force heaven or anything like that. It's just fun. Like, just plain and simple, it's fun. I cannot wait until we get a next-gen, like, Vekoma Thrill Coaster. I'm so excited. This ride's amazing, so, yeah. I think we're gonna go to Mystery Mine next. Got off of Mystery Mountain. That ride was funky. Two vertical lift hills, couple inversions. That ride's weird. That's weird. Keep your head forward, just because if you put it against the headrest, it really hurts. So, but yeah, Mystery Mountain, pretty fun. Okay, I got another back row ride on Mystery Mine. Pretty good ride. And then I just did Fire Chaser Express. This is a good ride. I mean, honestly, the air, I forget. There's this one hill where you're going backwards so you don't know, but it gives way more air than you think it's gonna give. It's amazing. Like, this ride is also really long. This is one of my favorite family coasters. I say this is on par with Dragon Flyer just because I love Dragon Flyer, but yeah, that's pretty good. And then
we saw mechanics working on Wild Eagle, so Wild Eagle is closed for the time being. So that's unfortunate, but let's go do Tennessee Tornado. So yeah.
We just got off of Tennessee Tornado in the back row. Dude, that thing is actually really fun. The drop is crazy. You're driving into a tunnel, and it's positive G-Force heaven all the way through. And it's really smooth for an era. It almost seems like a classic B&M. It's striking. It's almost like Kumba, but actually smooth and actually good. Shots fired. Tennessee Tornado is actually really, really good. So, yeah.
Tennessee Tornado. Get like really good floater over the top, despite it still being a little slow. Dude, this thing is a machine. I still don't know where it ranks yet. Because it's so much to take in, it's just non-stop, because you don't even get a lift hill. Like, you hit the launch, it's non-stop to the brake line. So you really gotta take, several rides to really soak in the experience. But it's unbelievable. Yeah, still a bit of a rough patch by the end of the wave turn all the way to the second twist and shout. I feel like they just retrack that with the steel track, but then it would absolutely be a flawless ride. This thing is a machine. I love this thing. Yeah, this thing is amazing. Okay, so quite a lot of time has passed since that last clip. Let's see, I rode Lightning Rod a couple times. I did Thunderhead. Did quite a few rides, but I just got off of Wild Eagle, which just opened for the day, maybe 30 minutes ago or so. It's probably like 1 or 2 in the afternoon. That's the best wing coaster I've ever ridden. I do it.
previously my favorite was X-Flight over Gatekeeper. I wish this ride had that slow, you know, inline twist that X-Flight has. But in general, like, this ride, like, there's a drop, there's an airtime hill, it's just, this is a great ride, alright? This is the best, this is the first wind coaster in the U.S. and the best, in my opinion, in the U.S. So, this thing craps all over it, Gatekeeper, and it's a little bit better than X-Flight. So yeah, let's, that said, I'm just gonna walk around the park, get a couple more re-rides, get some footage, and yeah. Okay, so I just did, so many rides. I just rode Tennessee Tornado in the front row, which by far is a front row ride. Other than the drop, but man, it's so smooth and it's so amazing in the front. I'm shocked that that's an error. So yeah, that's amazing. I also did Fire Chaser Express in the front. That ride's also a front row ride. I love that ride. Seriously, Fire Chaser Express is one of my favorite family coasters. Yeah, let's see. At some point I did Dragonflyer in the back row instead of the front. At this point I think I have 8 rides on Lightning Rod. that ride literally does not get old. I also marathoned Thunderhead for short time. That ride is unreal. I love it. It's seriously, it's amazing. Alright. I love that ride. So yeah, I do not have the Blazing Fury credit, so now that it's a 0 minute wait, where's the TV? It's not a Twitch. But yeah, it said a 0 minute wait. So, and earlier it was a long wait, so yeah, I'm gonna go do that. Alright, just did Blazing Fury. Didn't really get any off ride there, just cause, you can't really see anything, it's all in the dark. And it's all indoors. But, pretty solid ride. Pretty good airtime. During the few drops that it has. And while riding, actually, because there's a lot of like straight sections that it just shows you some props and stuff. And while I was riding that, I thought to myself, dude, there's not a single bad ride at this park. If any single roller coaster here closes, I would be sad. Other than the Kitty Credit, which I already have. But, like, there isn't a single, like, bad roller coaster here. Like, I'm shocked by that. There's always, almost at every park, there's that one ride. It's like, it's kind of on the way out. It could leave. I wouldn't really care. No, there's not a single ride here that fits that profile. Every single ride here is so much fun. I mean, granted, Blazing Fury isn't the best ride, but I don't hate it. I don't not like it. It's just a fun little ride. I love this park, man. I love this park.
Day 2.
Hi guys, we in the park. We are on Show Street. So we're going to go over to Timber Canyon and get a couple rides on Thunderhead. It's super hot today. We lucked out yesterday. It had like a 40% chance of rain, but it was cloudy for some of the day, but it was very chilly. Well, it wasn't chilly, but it was more like, it was on the colder side. Just the right temperature to the point where you're not cold, but you're not like sweating ridiculously. Yeah, it's the opposite today. It's a hot one today. So we seriously lucked out because yesterday was my full day when we had the fast passes. So yeah. No one can tell me that Thunderhead is not one of the best rides in the world. Thunderhead is a freaking airtime machine. Now, do note, it's the only GCI I've ridden. So I don't have much experience with GCIs, but so far it's been amazing. And just coming up here, nonetheless, we got Thunderhead. It's 9:30, so nothing's open yet, but they let people into the park. They open all the rides at 10:30, or at 10. We're around there. So, with all that said, let's go catch a ride on Thunderhead. I'm a GCI fanboy. This thing is absolutely bonkers. All right, top 5 for sure. Like this, I cannot even emphasize enough how fantastic this ride is. one of the best rides I've ever ridden. I mean, listen, last week in my Mount Olympus vlog, I said Zeus was amazing. Nah. Thunderhead all the way. Okay, so I just had one of the best trips of my life at Dollywood. Every single coaster here is at the very least good, and there's no coaster here that I don't like. Even the kiddie coasters were fun. Like I liked them. This is one of the greatest parks an enthusiast can go to, because not only Lightning Rod, but also Thunderhead is it's ridiculous, honestly. But yeah, that'll be it for Dollywood. So thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. See you guys in the next video. Goodbye.